doing nothing. I wonder if you go to the health club, do you put on the suit and just watch? Wonder if you can lose weight going to the facility, being dressed properly, but not touching any of the equipment. And because you're there, I feel weight falling off. I think you are crazy. When you get in a certain place, you must dress with proper attire, and you must then do what the attire says do. And for the spirit of heaviness, put on the garment of praise. And when you get to the praise house, you got to lay aside every weight. See, people don't want to do this. I got 13 minutes. Be seated. Sit quickly now, y'all. Sit. Come up here. Hurry up now. If you ain't gonna hurry, then I'm gonna use him. I don't want you being cool. Come on. And lay flat on your back and stay there for the rest of the service. Thank you. He feel crazy too. This is the position that the man in the text is in every service. Stay there, don't move. This is what he has to experience. He's at the gate. Everybody that goes to this church for prayer has to walk by him, step over him. Oh, yeah. Now, that's the position he's in. Oh, y'all might. This is what he has to feel every service. Every service. And I know y'all acting deep like you ain't never been stepped over before, but this is what he has to feel. I mean, you praising God, the person near you acting like they don't see you, that looks like this. That just. You need a miracle, you screaming, they look like they don't care. That looks just like this. I'm about to close because y'all look a little too tired. But then what happens is Peter and John are highly anointed. They are about to go into prayer, but except when they get near him, something won't let them step over him. Because I prophesied to 13 folk who will yell, this year somebody's coming in your direction that's going to help you. They ain't going to ignore you and act like you don't exist, because right now your life is handicapped. They've come to give you what you've been waiting. They can't go in. Peter and John refuses to go into prayer. What good is ritual when there's no miracle? They begin to interview who's on the ground. Oh, yeah. Basically, they say, I know you can't answer it because you didn't read the Bible about this. Who are you? So and so. Who brought you here? My mother. Where's your father? Never met him. How long you been in this church? Since I was a baby. How often do you come? Every day. How come you are a part of a ministry that you are faithful to since you are a kid? Y'all don't hear me. And that ministry's anointing can't get you up. Well, sir, I love my church, and what I do is I beg for alms so I can still pay my tithe and offering. Y'all ain't... Oh, y'all mighty quiet. I still give to my church, but my church ain't giving to me. He says, I've accepted being down here. Peter and John said, well, not after today. Y'all ain't talking. They said, we broke. Silver and gold have I none. I wish I had a church so I could do this. But such as I have, which it should read, who I have. Which means I didn't come to your ministry to find God. I came with God to bring God to your ministry. Y'all, when I grab your hand, jump up. Can you do that? And it said, and he told the man, look on us. And the man looked on them expecting to receive something. He would not have expected to receive something if they didn't look like something. Because the first thing you got to do to get the best season is fake it till you make it. Because you're broke, don't look broke. Because you're by yourself, don't look desperate. Because you ain't got a job, don't look unemployed. You let every person know it's still all about me. And then let the devil know if I ever get up from here. Yeah, if you think I'm bad flat on my back, wait on my feet. I wish I had a church now. If you are still in your right mind, flat on your back, how powerful are you going to be when you reach out and he leaps? He leaping up, stood, walking, leaping, praising God. All God said was, I let you go through this because I wanted you to understand the only reason why I'm going to get you up is I want a public display of how you feel about me. I ain't getting you up just to drive a Mercedes or a Maybach or a Hummer or Escalade. I'm getting you up so you can tell folk when I was down, he lifted me. When I was sick, he healed me. When I was lonely, he comforted me. If I got away.